Hi students, this is Professor Varun Shenoy reporting for a session on leadership attitude and industry analysis. Hope you are all safe, fine, secure and sound. Last class, I would like to refresh you. We touched upon attitude, behavior, the ABC model of attitude and behavior of a leader to know his or her psychological self, to determine the managing and leadership and captaining capabilities to run a venture, run a business organization, government, or any other opportunities in stature, in government or business stature. We also studied the theories of leadership, types of leadership, elements of leadership, and I also elaborated or elucidated on different types of successful leaders like Ratan Tata, and I also have discussed about how he designed a Nano for the working middle class population of India. I also spoke about Sri Kumar Mangalam Birla. I have also spoken about Kiran Majumdar Shaw, female leaders. I hope you are now having a role model as your leader to follow on footsteps and develop your abilities and capabilities for the success of your leadership learnings. So today's session will be on strategies to develop one's management and leadership abilities. So you have to develop your leadership and management abilities. Developing management skills is absolutely essential for all the students of BBA. According to World Economic Forum, people management is one of the top 10 skills needed to thrive in today's workforce. So, as I told you, survival is dependent on your leadership abilities and managerial abilities in the workplace. Gallup, a research firm, says that the talented managers experience greater profitability, increased level of productivity and higher employee engagement scores, highlighting how vital leadership and management is essential in an organization, its culture and its success. So the question now is how you are going to improve your leadership skills and management skills. Now you know which theory to adopt in what situation and what circumstances and to what method of leadership styles you can adopt to become successful in the entire process. So the first and the foremost important thing to develop your leadership is you have to practice. Practice makes a man perfect, there is a saying. So you have to strengthen your decision making abilities under pressure situation. Every day or every minute you will be solving one or the other problem, or the day is throwing challenges. This pandemic or epidemic of COVID-19 was also a challenge, which means the educational leadership and the leadership at the government levels successfully transitions and transformed to ensure online classes were administered and the syllabus was executed to ensure that no students lost their year. Similarly, even in organizations, the managers have taken up such decision making. So how you can develop your decision making? So take charge, take ownership, accountability and responsibility in your day-to-day life. Start managing your pocket money, start saving your pocket money, start saving your time, innovate, invent something, invent or innovate or find something of doing things differently. See how your knowledge can solve people's problem. Be empathetic. So you should also know how to manage your conflicts. Conflicts are common in a human life as well as both the professional life as well as personal life. There is various methods of solving conflicts. Even in your student days, you may be seeing conflicts within your family, within the classes, classmates. So you should be a mediator or a moderator to ensure that the conflicting parties are brought together and the problem is solved. You have to be considerate. So consideration abilities for a leader can be developed by doing some social responsibility. Please go out and give your old clothes to somebody. You will feel a sense of purpose. Similarly, when you train in these areas and then you proceed or go towards the organization, you can definitely find out that you have made a difference. Cultivate self-awareness. You need to understand who you are, my dear students. Self-awareness is inventing oneself to know who or she is. What are your emotions? Do a SWOT analysis of yourselves. SWOT, strength for S, W for weakness, O for opportunity, and T for threat is a kind of analysis which every student will have to do to know what are their inherent strength, their weakness, their opportunities and threats. When a person understands himself fully, he is called as Shaktiman or he is known as powerful man. A human being who has well known himself inside him through his conscience will know him better. So if you want to lead through your leadership, you need to first understand yourself. If you have to be a successful manager, then you have to manage small things in your life and yourself first. So this is the mantra of the strategies to develop one's leadership abilities. The first one was developing decision making. The second one was cultivating self-awareness. And in decision making, there were points such as to manage fights and conflict within yourself and outside the your world. And you have to be very considerate towards people, towards phenomena, towards situation. You have to be empathetic. You must be able to see things from your perspective and other perspective. You have to introspect yourself. You have to outrospect yourselves. So I have also given the example of Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Captain Cool, and versus Shri Virat Kohli, who is an aggressive captain. So each personality throws some energy upon to you as to what kind of leadership they have donned on themselves. So please develop your emotional intelligence. You should not get sad for small things. You must be able to control your anger. So, in a leader, he should view all emotions equally. In a leader, you should always ensure that the victory is same as defeat. So survival and long-term innings should be focus of a successful leader. And as I told you, you should have a cause in life. Without cause, there is no leader, remember. I would also like you to go to the net and find out certain websites which can do self-assessment of your leadership abilities for free. Definitely, over the course of time, I will be sharing few of workables for you, which you can develop or assess yourself to see by answering few psychological questions to know whether you are fit or ready, or you are having that element inside you, what takes you to be a leader or manager. The third point is trust, or I would say the personal soft skills or emotional soft skills. That is, you should be honest, you should be loyal, you should be committed, you should be trustworthy, you should be proactive. So this research, what I am talking today, is based from various top business schools of the world. You must have heard about the Harvard Business School. So you can look into Harvard Business Review over internet and find out certain interesting topics to develop your skills of leadership and manager. Communication skills, as always, stands number one to develop your leadership. Whatsoever is the language, it should be business. Remember this if you are a business leader. Whatsoever may be the language, it is to be political if you are a political leader. So, each profession requires leadership and managerial skills. I am sure through this subject and my teaching, you students are able to take up leadership role post your BBA. You have to maintain a checklist to see where you are deviating from the skills that has been established on this regards. You must be a hard worker as well as smart workers. Meaning, if something has to be designed, you must be able to work a longer time in the day. Every leadership role in a corporate requires enormous amount of work hours. As normal workers are working between, let's say, 9 to 5 as a timing, for senior leadership and leadership abilities, you have to come out of the box and stretch to make policies and regulations for the people who trust you and whom you depend upon for delivery of work or profit. Please develop an entrepreneurial mindset. Please develop a risk-taking behavior. These are the skills under which the leadership and management concept lies, my dear friends. So the base is risk-taking and entrepreneurial mindset. You must be able to diversify your interests, your work areas, so that you fit to any kind of jobs. It's very important. So you have to maintain a checklist. Have I ironed my clothes today? Have I kept my shoes in order? Have I bought certain groceries to my house? Try to shoulder yourself to with your parents in terms of earning. Try to take a part-time job. Develop your skills. So these are the essential ingredients how you can develop your leadership skills. When you develop leadership skills, automatically employability skill follows with you. Those who are planning to get only employment and practice employability skills will fit only to employability, or they get just a job. Whereas those students who always research upon how to develop leadership skills, employability follows with them. That is the magic of leadership skills. If you have any questions, please write it down so that, or discuss it in the Google Classroom so that I am able to reply it. Reflection, very important thing for a leader. You have to reflect upon your actions. What you did was right, or what you did was wrong, or should I need to raise it or escalate to somebody who can give you the advice that is essential. If you don't reflect yourself, my dear friends, you cannot learn. So learning is a process where you will be able to reflect as to what you learned. For example, after seeing these videos, you must be able to break down in your mind or in a book that what are the important points I theoretically spoke. So due to the constraints in online or video lectures, we are unable to do a practical simulation. But I promise you that once we catch up in the classroom, we are going to do a lot of leadership simulative exercise, display of leadership behavior in the time of crisis. Now, when I speak about crisis, what is crisis management? An unforeseen or unpredictable death in the family, a sudden shock or trauma-inducing event, death of a friend. So, certain losses in the life, the leader has to learn to manage it with valor and pride. So how you do it is because you have to practice and sharpen your mind in this regards. You have to reflect upon yourself, who you are, what you have done, what you have learned today, how you will be in demand. You have to develop your demand value or market value, because you are in the fifth semester. If somebody has to give you, sorry, you are in the second year, that is third semester, okay, whichever semester of BBA, you have to reflect upon yourself that the further semester where you come in, somebody has to offer you internship for your project that has to be submitted to university, or you will have to get a job. So you have to see how you can develop your skills and what you can add to your personality so that you get automatically employable, automatically offerable. So how much you have developed your selling skills. So sales skills are absolutely essential for a leader. That is why in our assessment, I have asked you to write an assessment about sales leadership. I think so, for which carries 10 marks. So you should be able to sell. It's all about salesmanship, sales closure, if you want to be a leader. Everybody is a salesman, from watchman to chairman. Constantly, the leader has to promote his organization to the stakeholders, his people, follow him and get the benefits to the stakeholders and again share it with the society. Schedule reflection sessions shortly after completing anything. After you finish your examination, find out what did I do today? How would I have answered this question in a different way? How I could have evidenced this question so that the reader could have understood it in a better way? How can I convince is a constant reflective question you have to think about yourself. Whether you are talking to your parents or you are talking to your lecturers or maybe talking to your company guides in future, you have to ask, how can I convince? So, these are the skills which you must be able to focus upon to develop your leadership and managerial abilities. Now, let me tell you, my friend, you will also have to look what kind of student development training you can try to find out in an online sphere. Because whatever ingredients I have told you, you must be able to ensure that these things that is been taught is been constantly practiced. Practicing is very much essential. Without practicing, you cannot go forward. So practice, practice, practice. So how do you think Rohit Sharma or in IPL, people are able to score big shots, run for long? That is only because it is that they have practice. So if you also heard about coaching, so sports sector has lot of examples for leadership. So coach is somebody who teaches the players to survive, to have a strategy to feel while facing opposition. So just like sports, life and business is also a game for which needs captaincy and leadership. So behind a leader and a captain, there is always a coach or a guru. Remember this. So that is why I asked you to develop your role model. That means you have to find your guru as well, so that you develop your tactics, sharpen it, and come out as an effective leader. So that is it, my dear friends. These were the strategies on how you could develop your leadership and managerial abilities at this age, at teenage or early 20s in university. I hope this will open your mind to research more. So I'll catch you again in the next class, and you have all a good day and stay safe. Bye bye.